Today is June 5th. On the 5th of June 1981, the Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report of the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention reports that 5 people in Los Angeles, California have a rare form of pneumonia only seen in patients with weakened immune systems. These will turn out to be the first recognized cases of a particular condition caused by a retrovirus. Of which disease were these the first recognized cases? Hello and welcome to a new season of Smarter by the Second. Our guest today is Paul. Welcome, Paul. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. It's lovely to be on here and break in the new season, yeah. The new set.
You came all the way from Galway, I believe.
Yeah, Galway, Ireland. I'm currently visiting my friend Ronan for the week, and I'm a maths graduate as well, like himself.
Okay. Nice.
And I'm actually currently learning to be an English teacher to teach in Japan for a year.
Oh, sick. Okay.
That's yeah, you can cool. Visit. Don't worry.
I can visit. Okay. Yeah, tell us more about yourself, your hobbies, what makes you tick.
Well, I wouldn't say I'm super into like arts and culture, which is why I skipped looking past that immediately.
Okay.
But I do watch my fair bit of movies. I do like some video games, some anime, just plenty of variety.
What's your favorite movie?
A movie I watched recently, which I really liked, because it's hard to choose, would be Past Lives.
It's
really, really good, a Korean film.
Yeah, Lavinia wrote, I think, an article about that.
Yeah, we actually watched it together when she visited.
I haven't seen it yet.
You should. You will.
Yeah? Should I? Okay.
You should, yeah.
Okay. Oh, maybe I will. I think we'll just start with the first round.
Sounds good.
I wish you good luck.
I'll need it.
Get ready for a cinematic adventure with A24, the indie powerhouse that's taken the movie world by storm. Since bursting onto the scene in 2012, A24 has been the go-to for films that are anything but ordinary. Whether it's spine-chilling horror, heartwarming dramas, or mind-bending sci-fi, A24 movies always keep us on the edge of our seats. This round, we're diving into the weird and wonderful world of A24. So here are 9 A24 movies with a description. So I will read a description of the movie, it's just one sentence.
Yeah.
And you will have to guess the name of the movie. You can choose from Priscilla, Moonlight, Everything Everywhere All at Once, After Sun, Pearl, Past Lives, Uncut Gems, Lady Bird, and Midsommar. Do you know any of these movies?
Thank God, I do.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There's like all artsy-fartsy, I don't know.
Yeah. Some of them are.
We have like a lot of art house sort of theaters in Ireland.
Well, like for movies, like we have one that's actually partnered with the same artsy cinema that's here. It's called Palos. So they've shown your Everything Everywheres and your Past Lives, and I've seen Uncut Gems in my own time. But yeah.
Oh yeah, I saw that on Netflix, I think.
Oh, it's so good.
Yeah, I don't know, I didn't finish it. I forgot
about well?
It. Are you well? I don't know.
Right.
Okay, well, let's start. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you need 5 correct answers, by the way.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Okay. Well, so this movie follows the life of a young African-American man, Kyron, as he grows up in a rough Miami neighborhood while grappling with his identity and sexuality.
Moonlight.
You can answer before I'm finished.
Oh, yeah.
A reflective drama about a woman looking back on a holiday she took with her father in her youth, exploring themes of memory and loss.
Lady Bird.
A horror film about a group of friends who travel to Sweden for a
Midsommar.
Festival. A psychological horror film that serves as a prequel to X, focusing on a young woman with dreams of stardom who
Pearl.
Descends. A thriller about a charismatic New York City jeweler.
Uncut Gems.
A coming-of-age drama about a high school senior in Sacramento navigating the challenges of teenage life, family dynamics, and her aspirations for the future.
Pass.
A romantic drama that explores the relationship between 2 childhood friends from
Past
South Korea. A biological drama about Elvis Presley's wife.
Priscilla.
A genre-bending film about a woman who discovers she must connect with a parallel universe.
Everything Ever All at Once.
Okay.
And then the one I didn't do was After Sun.
Okay. Okay. And we'll stop the time.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to use any lifelines?
I'll just use one.
One?
Yeah.
You need 5 correct answers.
Yeah. Okay. Do you not believe me?
Okay, you can use one. Okay. So, we'll use one lifeline. Okay. So the first one, if this movie follows the life of a young African-American man named Kyron as he grows up in a rough Miami neighborhood while grappling with his identity and sexuality, that is Moonlight, a reflective drama about a woman looking back on a holiday she took with her father in her youth, exploring themes of memory and loss. That's After Sun, a horror film about a group of friends who travel to Sweden for a festival that takes a sinister turn as they become involved in disturbing pagan rituals. That's Midsommar, a psychological horror film that serves as a prequel to X, focusing on a young woman with dreams of stardom who descends into madness. That's Pearl, a thriller about a charismatic New York City jeweler who makes a series of high-stakes bets that could lead to the windfall of a lifetime, but risks everything he has. That's Uncut Gems, a coming-of-age drama about a high school senior in Sacramento navigating the challenges of teenage life, family dynamics, and her aspirations for the future. That's Lady Bird, a romantic drama that explores the relationship between two childhood friends from South Korea who are reunited in adulthood, reflecting on their past and present connections. That's Past Lives, a biological drama about Elvis Presley's wife, depicting her life and relationship with Elvis Presley from their first meeting to their eventual separation. Spoiler alert. That's Priscilla. No, a genre-bending film about a woman who discovers she must connect with parallel universe versions of herself to prevent a powerful being from destroying the multiverse. That's Everything, Everywhere, All at Once. Okay. So, okay. You didn't need Lifeline, but you all go to the next round anyway.
Whew.
Are you feeling nervous?
Of course I am. Yeah. Jesus.
Okay.
I'm on the big stage, you know?
Yeah. It's going to be all right. We'll just go on with the next one.
Right. Sounds good. Okay.
The Jackson 5 singing their song Do Re Mi. A, B, C is easy, just like counting up to three. We will put that to the test in this round. Although we will go all the way up to 10 in this round, there are 9 songs with numbers in the title. So you will hear, the song, and then you will to guess the title, and all of them have numbers from like 1 to 10. So we have One Dance, Just the Two of Us, Three Little Birds, 4 out of 5, 6 Degrees of Separation, 7 Years, 8 Mile, 9 to 5, and 10 Feet Tall. You recognize them?
I do.
Half.
But don't think I'll have many lifelines.
Which would be your favorite out of these?
You know, 9 to 5, love a bit of Dolly Parton.
Yeah,
you a big
she's
fan?
She's amazing.
She's amazing.
I love all her songs. 9
all
to
of them.
5.
Yeah.
Jolene. The others? I don't
know. all the others, the whole discography.
Do you have like an all-time favorite song as well?
From Dolly Parton?
No, just like any artist in general.
I couldn't tell you off the top of my head. It changes from day to day.
Okay. Well, are you ready?
I am.
You need 5 correct answers for this one as well.
Okay.
So, we'll start with the first song then.
Sounds good. Pass. I'm 10 feet tall. Just the two of us. One Dance. Six Degrees of Separation. Four out of 5. 9 to 5.
Yeah.
Three Little Birds. 7 years old. Oh, and it's the last one I said pass on, then time?
Yeah, okay.
Oh, I thought I missed one. Sugar.
Do you think you have 5 correct?
No.
No?
I'm going to use... Oh, sugar. I'm going to gamble. How, do I need 5, yeah? I'm going to go 2 lifelines.
2 lifelines, okay.
Cross my fingers.
Okay. Well, okay. 2 lifelines.
What do you think?
I think...
Three lifelines it is. No. Right, three lifelines.
Three?
Three.
Okay, then you have one left.
Yeah.
You know how...
Oh, fine, two. Two, okay. Okay. I'll stop hemming and hawing. That's it. End of story.
Okay, two. Okay, two lifelines then.
If I lose here, it's deserved.
Okay, let's have a look at your answers. Yeah, so for the first one, what did you guess? You guessed three little birds. And it was actually 10 feet tall. And then, so that one's incorrect. But, so here you guessed 4 out of 5. Which is actually Three Little Birds by Bob Marley.
Oh!
One of his most famous songs. It doesn't matter.
I just didn't know the name.
Still, you had a lifeline, so it's counted as correct. Okay, so this one you guessed the two of us, and that one was correct.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Just a two. Okay, so here you guessed one dance, and that's also correct.
Yeah, big Drake fan.
Yeah? Team Drake or Team Kendrick?
You know.
Here you guessed 10 feet tall.
That's wrong.
It was, I think, 8 Mile.
Oh, I did. How did I clock that?
Okay, so you need. Okay, so you need one more correct. So the next one, you guessed 8 Mile. And this was, in fact, what was it? Six degrees of separation? Yeah, 6 degrees of separation. So that's also incorrect.
Who is this?
Don't know, some emo artist, probably La Fignelli's sister. I don't know. Okay, so this was 9 to 5 by Dolly, Queen. And this is, of course, correct.
Oh!
Yeah, she did it again. She did it again.
Coming in the final hour.
So you're through to the next round.
Yeah.
Okay, so here you got 6 degrees of separation. And this was, in fact, 4 out of 5 by Arctic Monkeys.
Yeah.
That's my favorite band.
I knew the artist, just not the song.
Ah, okay.
I'm the worst with names.
And then for the last song, you guessed 7 years. And this is, of course, 7 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one was real famous back in the day.
Yeah, I think this is his only big song. I don't remember anything else from him, because I don't remember his name.
No, he's like a one-hit wonder, I think. Yeah. Okay, but you're through to the next round. You have 2 lifelines left.
Okay.
How are you feeling?
Very confident.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I can see it. I see a confident man.
Yeah.
Well, I think you're doing all right. So, yeah. Let's just go to the next round.
Yeah.
The Club of 27 refers to a group of influential musicians who all passed away at the age of 27. The term was coined in the 1970s after the deaths of Jim Morrison from The Doors and other famous musicians who remain nameless, since they are answers to this round. It has since been used to describe the untimely deaths of other artists who died at the same age. While the idea of a club might seem morbid, the impact that these musicians had on the music world cannot be understated. Their music continues to inspire and influence new generations of artists, and the circumstances surrounding their deaths have sparked much speculation and interest. Since there weren't enough super famous musicians who died at 27, here are 9 musicians who died before they reached the age of 30. Okay, so I will give a description of like the artist,
mm-hmm.
And then you have to guess the name.
So okay.
You can choose from Jimi Hendrix, Ian Curtis, Kurt Cobain, Amy Winehouse, Cliff Burton, Janis Joplin, Tupac, Avicii, and Juice WRLD. You recognize him?
I don't know who Cliff Burton is, but the rest are...
Yeah, okay, so I will just describe a sort of...
Yeah.
What they did as a musician and how they died as well. And
oh, Jesus. That's a bit, okay.
Yeah.
Ooh.
We're not in
well, I'll
not
probably,
too
yeah,
much detail.
Yeah, appreciate it. Images popping up. Ah!
Okay. You don't need 5. You now need 6 correct answers.
Okay.
So, okay, we're upping the stakes a bit.
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm locked in.
Yeah. Okay. She was an English singer-songwriter performing soul, rhythm, and blues and jazz.
Amy Winehouse.
Okay. He was a famous DJ in 2018. He was the frontman of the grunge band Nirvana. He was found
Kurt Cobain.
He was a famous rapper. His official cause of death was a result of oxycodone.
Juice WRLD.
Yeah. He was a frontman for the post-punk group Joy Division. He suffered from epilepsy and depression. He was the bassist for Metallica.
Jimi Hendrix.
She was an American singer and one of the most successful and widely known rock stars of her era.
Janis Joplin or Janis.
He is regarded as one of the best rappers of all time. He was fatally. He is seen as one of the most talented guitarists ever. The post-mortem examination concluded that he inhaled his own vomit and died of asphyxia while intoxicated with the
Ian Curtis. Blood. And then the last one's Clint Burton.
And you, okay. And then stop the time.
Stop.
Okay. Do you want to use any lifeline?
I will.
For six.
Let me have a quick go.
You can look through which one.
Yeah, so I know I feel confident in Jimmy and Kurt. Jimmy, Kurt, Amy, Tupac, Avicii, and Juice WRLD. So
that's six.
That is six, it's true. Got that degree's paying off, come on. All right, no lifelines.
No lifelines.
Now or never.
Just raw dogging it.
Raw dog.
Let's go. It's okay, we're not PG.
We're not PG.
Okay.
Wait, so I can curse?
Yeah, we won't get demonetized, I think. We don't have enough viewers.
Oh, damn.
Okay, but we will one day. Okay. Okay, the first one. She was an English singer and songwriter, performing soul, rhythm, blues and jazz. She died in 2011 in her bathtub due to alcohol poisoning. You guessed Amy Winehouse, and it was correct. It was Amy Winehouse. He was a famous DJ. In 2018, he committed suicide while on holiday in Oman. In 2019, his third and final album, Tim, was released posthumously. You guessed Avicii, and it was Avicii. So, the frontman of the grunge band Nirvana, he was found dead in his home in 1994 after committing suicide. You guessed Kurt Cobain, which is correct. He was a famous rapper. His official cause of death was a result of oxycodone and codeine toxicity. This happened in 2019. So you guessed Juice WRLD, which is correct. He was the frontman for the post-punk group Joy Division. He suffered from epilepsy and depression and died by suicide in 1980 on the eve of Joy Division's first North American tour, shortly before the release of their new album Closer. So you guessed Jimi Hendrix, and this was in fact Ian Curtis. Okay. Then he was the bassist for Metallica. He was killed on tour in 1986 when the tour bus fell on top of him after he fell out. So you guessed Ian Curtis, and this was Cliff Burton. So she was an American singer and one of the most successful and widely known rock stars of her era. She died of a heroin overdose in 1970. So you guessed Janis Joplin, and this is correct. He is regarded as one of the best rappers of all time. He was fatally shot in 1996 in a drive-by shooting in Las Vegas. So you guessed Tupac, which is correct, which means you have passed as well. Okay, and then lastly, he is seen as one of the most talented guitarists ever. So the post-mortem examination concluded that he inhaled his own vomit and died of asphyxia while intoxicated with drugs. And that is, so you guessed Cliff Burton, but it was in fact Jimi Hendrix. So,
whoa.
Perfect, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Student perfect.
Student
we call
perfect.
It a student 10, because like 10 is the highest grade you can get in Holland.
Oh, yeah.
But when you just pass,
it's 5.5, isn't it?
Yeah, 5.5. Yeah. It's a student 10.
Phew.
It's basically the same.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's mad.
Oh, so, are you feeling a bit more confident now?
Did you see that round? that was the skin of my teeth.
You didn't use any lifelines.
Oh, so
you must be sort of getting more relaxed.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Should be okay. I feel confident.
Okay, that's good.
Midland.
Nice. Okay. Disney's Steamboat Willie has entered public domain in the United States as of January 1st, 2024. What most people do not know is that this is the first appearance of Mickey Mouse on the big screen. Perhaps less known is that it is also the first Disney film to include sound. Sound would play a pivotal role in Disney movies as songs became some of the most recognizable assets in most Disney films. In this round, we will hear 9 classic Disney songs. So you will hear the Disney song and you have to guess the movie in which it's used. So. You can choose from Aladdin, Mulan, The Lion King, Cinderella, Hercules, The Little Mermaid, Frozen, Pinocchio, and The Jungle Book. Are you a big Disney fan?
Everyone is a little bit. I have seen at least like nearly all of these films.
Yeah.
But there's some themes like for Pinocchio, you know, I don't know.
I don't think I've ever seen Pinocchio, to be fair. Maybe I have when I was small. I don't remember what. It was like
exact same.
It was like a big fish or something.
A big fish?
In Pinocchio.
Oh, the whale! And then he eats them and then they live happily ever after.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so you will hear the song and you have to guess the movie.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's get on with it. Let's play the first song.
Yeah. Aladdin. When you wish upon a star. Pass. Tell me, princess, now when did you last? Cinderella. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm Pass. The girl? And can you feel the love tonight? Hercules. Pinocchio. Frozen. The crowds will cheer when they see my face. And the voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be. The Jungle Book. Look for the that's the Jungle Book. And then the one I just said was The Lion King. And then the last two were Mulan and The Little Mermaid in order. And Time.
Time is good. Okay. Do you want to use your lifeline?
Why would you ask that? Or, you know I can't.
You can.
Can I?
Or, oh no, you don't have any time. Okay.
You can't matter. Play with my emotions Sorry. Like this, man. Look at that. Ah! Ref!
So, we will guess. Do you think you have six correct?
Do I look it?
Not really. No, but, no. Who knows? Who knows?
I know.
Okay. Let's check your answers. So, for the first song, you guessed Pinocchio and
no!
Mulan. So this is incorrect. Then for the second, you guessed Cinderella, but this was Pinocchio. So also not correct. So only room left for one error. So here you guessed Mulan, but this was in fact Aladdin.
Yeah.
Okay, so you need all correct.
Yeah.
So okay, for this one you guessed The Little Mermaid, and this was The Little Mermaid.
Ah! Right, the game!
Then next song, you guessed Hercules.
No. Well,
here we can hear Elton John sing for The Lion King. So, I'm sorry, you won't pass in the next one. Sorry. Now, okay, for the sixth one, you guessed Aladdin, but this was Cinderella, of course.
Oh, it is.
The famous scene where they're with the godmother, I think. I'm not sure, actually. Now, the seventh one, you guessed Frozen.
Yeah.
And this is, of course, Frozen.
Yeah.
Iconic song.
Big fan? Okay.
Yeah, huge. I'm a Elsa fan, you know. Okay, and we have the next one. You guessed Lion King, but this was Hercules. So not correct. Then the last one, you guessed The Jungle Book, and this was correct, but yeah, it's not enough. So, well, it's a shame, so we won't be seeing you in the next episode.
You'll never see me again, I'll be gone.
Aww.
I know.
But we have a gift for you.
For me?
For participating.
Wait, for me?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
You have a nice cloak.
Lukewarm. Yeah.
But drink it lukewarm. Yeah.
I have a gift for you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. What do you think it is?
It's
not a big hug. That's cheating. A ring.
Yeah.
That'd be a cool one. Oh, I'd love a ring. Nah.
Oh my God.
Not the brand.
No branding.
No branding. You know, we don't have the license.
Unidentified
for that.
Irish beer.
Yeah. The good one. The good one.
I love this. I love this.
Yeah. Well, cheers.
Cheers. Hi, welcome back. And now we are joined by a new contestant, Eva.
Hi.
Hello. Welcome to the Barbie Dreamhouse.
Hi, Ken.
How are you feeling? Bonita.
Yes, I'm feeling very bonita.
Nice. Okay, so you participated last year in media. I think you went to the final rounds. You did pretty well.
Do
you
think I tried my best.
Better, even better in arts and literature?
Maybe, but probably not. I think I got very lucky last time.
I don't think it was luck. You did really well.
Thank
you. Don't cut yourself down. But what is the specific reason for picking this category?
Well, I took an AP Art History class in high school, and I vaguely remember stuff from it. Okay. So that makes me feel very qualified.
I think it's good to vaguely remember stuff for this general knowledge quiz. Oh, nice. Okay. Well, I hope you do well. I hope you win, actually.
Let's not push it.
Okay, no. You'll do fine. Okay, so first round. English literature seems to be predominantly taught in Northern Europe, often being read more often than the country's own literature. The only hindrance to this phenomena is the ever-growing popularity of American literature, which occupies a more and more relevant role in schools. Here are then 9 American writers and their best-known novels. So, I will I'll read out the title of a novel, and you will have to match it with the correct author. You can choose from Herman Melville, Harper Lee, Nathaniel Hawthorne, Mark Twain, Ken Casey, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, okay, Louisa May Alcott, F. Scott Fitzgerald, J.D. Salinger, and Margaret Mitchell. Are these familiar to you anyhow?
A few, like 3.
3? Ah, okay, because you are American, we all know that.
Yes.
So, but do you feel more pressure now, or?
We'll see how this goes.
Okay, you need 5 correct answers. You still have 5 lifelines, so you could screw up and just use 5 lifelines. Okay, are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
I will read out the first question now. So, The Great Gatsby.
F. Scott Fitzgerald.
The Catcher in the Rye.
Nathaniel Hawthorne.
To Kill a Mockingbird.
This is a woman. Harper Lee?
Moby Dick?
J.D. Salinger?
The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn?
Oh, that's Mark Twain.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest?
Louisa May Alcott?
Little Women?
Oh, I should know this. Margaret Mitchell.
Gone with the Wind.
Ken Casey. Oh, Herman Melville.
The Scarlet Letter.
Ken Casey. Okay.
To switch.
Yes. Shoot. Nathaniel Hawthorne for The Scarlet Letter. And then who did Little Women? Yeah, I'll just do that.
Stop the time?
Stop the time.
Okay. Do you want to use any lifelines? Just count how much you know for sure. Or
3
lifelines? Okay. Yeah. Well, okay, so 3 lifelines. So that means you lose 48 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
But okay, so you need 2 correct answers. Well. So, the first one, The Great Gatsby, you answered, I think, F. Scott Fitzgerald, which was the correct answer. Then, The Catcher in the Rye, you answered Herman Melville, but it was J.D. Salinger. Okay, To Kill a Mockingbird, you answered Harper Lee, which was correct.
High school.
And Moby Dick, you said Margaret Mitchell, but it was Herman Melville. Then, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. Was Mark Twain, so it's correct, so you're already through to the next round. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, that you said J.D. Salinger, but it was Ken Casey. Then Little Women, you said Ken Casey, but that was Louisa May Alcott. Gone with the Wind, that you said Louisa May Alcott, but it was Margaret Mitchell. And then finally, The Scarlet Letter was Nathaniel Hawthorne, so you had that one correctly.
Oh, okay. I remember more from high school than I thought I did.
Yeah. Okay, so you need to have more confidence, I think.
Yeah.
That went all right.
I think I knew I was supposed to switch Louisa, but I forgot to say it.
I've only read The Catcher in the Rye. I had to read it for English, I think.
Yeah, I read Huckleberry Finn, and I read The Scarlet Letter.
Ah, okay. Are any of these nice? Or?
Oh, I also read Great Gatsby. They're fine.
Yeah, I don't
know. Some of them aren't my favorite.
I did
like Huckleberry.
I didn't like Catcher in the Rye. Thought it was, I don't know. It's fine. Okay. For the next round. Women and the female figure have served for many years as the artistic inspiration of many of the most famous paintings in the world. Between historical, mythical, motherly, sisterly, and lover figures, in the life of many painters, the female body is one that is often found in many works of art. Here are the 9 paintings of women and their titles. So, you'll get a picture, and you will also get sort of the person who made it. I will also name it, and a small description. So, you can choose from the Mona Lisa, Autoretrato con Collar de Espinas, I think, Whistler's Mother, A Woman with a Parasol, Olympia, The Birth of Venus, Girl with the Pearl Earring, Shot Marilyn, Marilyn's, okay, and A Portrait of Adele Bloch-Bauer the First.
I feel much more confident about this round.
Okay. Shall we just jump right in?
Yes.
Okay. So the first was by Edouard Manet.
This is Olympia.
By Leonardo da Vinci.
Mona Lisa.
By Johannes Vermeer.
This is A Woman with Pearl Earring.
By Claude Monet.
A Woman with Parasol.
By Sandro Botticelli.
Birth of Venus.
By Gustav Klimt, also known as The Woman in Gold. This painting was stolen by the Nazis in 1941 and displayed...
Portrait of Adele Bloch-Bauer.
By Frida Kahlo, also known as the self-portrait... By Andy
Shots
Warhol. By James McNeil.
Whistler's Mother.
Okay, stop the time.
Stop the time.
Okay. Need any lifelines?
I don't think so.
You felt really you were really sure of yourself. Okay. Well, let's check the answers. So, first one by Edouard Manet. The French government acquired this painting in 1890 after a public subscription organized by Claude Monet. This painting is now in the Musée d'Orsay in Paris. This is Olympia. By Leonardo da Vinci, also known as La Gioconda. Gioconda or something. This is the Mona Lisa. Okay, by Johannes Vermeer, during the Dutch Golden Age, it hangs in the Mauritshuis in The Hague. And this is the Girl with the Pearl Earring. Then by Claude Monet, this impressionist work depicts his wife Camille Monet and their son Jean Monet. That's A Woman with the Parasol. Actually, I have a poster of that in my room. Okay, by Sandro Botticelli, hangs in the Uffizi in Florence. This is The Birth of Venus. By Gustav Klimt, also known as The Woman in Gold, this painting was stolen by the Nazis in 1941 and displayed at the Österreichische Galerie Belvedere. That's the portrait of Adele Bloch-Bauer the First. And I already skipped over it, but you passed. That's why you have 5 correct, sorry. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Then this one by Frida Kahlo, also known as Self-Portrait with Thorn Necklace and Hummingbird. That's the Autoretrato con Collar de Espinas. So, correct. By Andy Warhol, who had a fascination with Hollywood and fame. That's the Shot Marilyn's. And then finally, by James McNeil Twister, also known as Arrangement in Grey and Black Number 1. It's Whistler's Mother. So, 9 correct.
Ooh. It's
really nice. So, you gain an extra lifeline as well.
Yes, I'm very happy about
congratulations.
That.
Congratulations. So, you're feeling a lot better, right?
Yes.
More confident after the first round.
We'll see what happens after this.
Okay, I think you'll be fine. The Colossus of Rhodes was a statue of the Greek sun god Helios. The statue was approximately 33 meters high and it erected in 280 BC. It collapsed during the earthquake of 226 BC, so all we have left are artists' impressions of what the statue probably looked like. Here are 9 famous statues that are still standing. So you get a picture and a name, and you have to guess where they are located.
Oh, all right, I will
try.
So
a sort of geography round for you a bit. So you can choose the places you can choose from are Giza, Rio de Janeiro, Paris, Copenhagen, Florence, New York, Easter Island, Brussels, and Gujarat.
Okay.
Have you ever been to any of these places?
I've been to Paris, I've been to New York, I've been to Brussels.
Nice. Okay.
So we're not completely off base.
Oh, yeah. You need 6 correct answers for this one, so it's a bit more than 5.
Okay.
Shall we start?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. First one, the Great Sphinx.
Egypt. Or Giza, yeah.
Christ the Redeemer.
Rio de Janeiro.
The Thinker.
Is in Paris.
The Little Mermaid.
Copenhagen.
the Statue of Unity.
Yeah, that
okay,
one.
Maui.
Easter Island.
David.
That's in Florence.
Manneke Pis.
Brussels.
And the Statue of Liberty.
That's in New York. Stop time.
Nice. Need any lifelines?
No, I don't think
okay,
so.
Okay, let's check them. So the first one was the Great Sphinx in Giza. Then we had Christ the Redeemer in Rio de Janeiro. Then the Thinker, that's in Paris. Then the Little Mermaid in Copenhagen. It's really small, this statue.
Really?
Yeah.
The Thinker's huge.
I haven't seen it. Hmm. Then we had the Statue of Unity in Gujarat. Then Moai on Easter Island, which means you have 6 correct answers. Nice. Okay, then we have David, Statue of David in Florence. Then Manneke Pis in Brussels.
And I've never seen that one.
The Statue of Liberty, of course, in New York. Yeah, I was also in Brussels, but I just walked past Manneke Pis.
I didn't even
really small.
Know
it's
that
like
one was
right
there.
In the center, but I just forgot about it and didn't see it. It's not that special. But
it happens.
Okay. Well, you even have like 4 lifelines now. You're gaining them back.
I'm redeeming myself after my first round.
Okay, round 4. I am Sam. I am Sam. Sam I am. That Sam I am. That Sam I am. I do not like that Sam I am. Do would you like green eggs and ham? These are the first few lines of the children's book Green Eggs and Ham by Theodore Seuss Geisel, better known as Dr. Seuss. Throughout his career, Dr. Seuss produced and created many characters that have shaped the childhood of many children across the world and which have inspired many adaptations of film. In this round, then, 9 of Dr. Seuss' famous characters.
We got this, I think.
Yeah, you got this.
I was in the musical, Seussical the Musical, so we're going to see.
The music, Seussical the Musical?
Seussical the Musical.
What is that about?
It's like about all those Dr. Seuss stories, but together.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Oh, that's really fun. Who did you play?
I was a background character. Okay. I was a dandelion at some point. My hair was dyed bright red.
You are one of the Who's.
Yeah.
Okay, we have the options you can choose from are the Grinch, Dr. Tailwhacker, the Fox, Thing One, Yertle the Turtle, the Lorax, the Cat in the Hat, Horton, and Vlad Vladikov.
All right.
Okay. Shall we start?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the first one is a protagonist of one of the companions. Protagonist
Cat
of this character is described
Horton
as the mean-spirited animal. He's the second antagonist in the book of Horton Hears a
Vlad Vladikov?
Bart Collins, bossy piano teacher who orders Bart to practice until he is perfect.
Dr. Tervickle?
He is the protagonist of the King of the Pond on the island.
Riddle the Turtle.
Voiced by Danny DeVito.
Lorax.
This. Stop.
Stop.
Okay. Any lifelines?
No, thank you.
No. Okay. Let's check them. So, the first one, it was the protagonist of a well-known children's book about Christmas. He has been voiced and interpreted by many, among which most famously Jim Carrey, that's the Grinch. That one of the companions of the Cat in the Hat and part of a set of human-like identical twins, that is Thing One. Then the protagonist of a book by the same name, this character is described to be 6 feet tall. That's the Cat in the Hat. This character is described as being simple-minded, a simple-minded animal with a heart of gold, who happens to also be surprisingly graceful. That is Horton. Then a mean-spirited animal, he's the second antagonist in the book Horton Hears a Who. That's Vlad Vladikov. Then Bart Collins, bossy piano teacher who orders Bart to practice until he is perfect and believes all other instruments worthless. He is believed to kidnap and enslave children. That's Dr. Tailwhacker. So that's 6 correct. Congratulations. Then the protagonist of the book, The Fox in the Socks. That's the fox.
In his socks.
King of the Pond on the island of Salamasond. That's Yertle the Turtle. And then, voiced by Danny DeVito, this character's official occupation is to speak for the trees. That's, of course, the Lorax.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, okay. So, You did this one well, perfect as well. So you have managed to regain all of your lifelines.
No. So. Do Dutch children read Dr. Seuss?
We know it, I think. Huh. And I've seen the Lorax. We don't really, I don't remember Dr. Seuss character. Not the books anyway. Just like the characters, I think.
It's a shame, because that's how I learned how to read with reading Dr. Seuss.
Ah, okay. Well, that was it for today's episode. The answer to today's viewer's question is AIDS. Congratulations to the winner. And see you next week.